I'm starting a new experimental project. I'm going to try and 3D print a kiln. This is a test batch of the clay, hand mixed in a bucket, which is a ton of work, by the way. It's a flameware body, which means it's resistant to uneven heating, or heat shock. This is the hard way to load a printer tube, but it works. This is a 10-centimeter cube for shrink and heat shock resistance tests. The surface texture is due to the paper in the clay, which causes it to tear as it extrudes. How did the heat shock test go? Not perfectly. But this is a pretty extreme test, and the best result of the bodies we've tried. So, fingers crossed? This is the firebox. It looks like some kind of neo-brutalist architecture to me, something right out of Dune. I like it, but I wouldn't want to live there. This is the main body of the kiln, printing. We hope the open cells of the infill will provide good insulation. In case you're wondering, the clay is so dark because it's full of mold from the paper fibers. As you can see, it's raining pretty hard, a perfect day to fire a kiln. Going in, we have a couple of green pieces, both paper and regular clay, thin and thick-walled, and a couple of bisque pieces bound with banana peels and copper wire to see if we can get some potassium or copper flashing. Also a cone back. We're starting the fire outside of the kiln and slowly pushing the coals in to prevent the temperature from rising too fast, a mistake I made with the paper clay kiln I test-fired last week. Check out the video for more on that. For the first half hour, the temperature is erratic, jumping and falling with the fire. At an hour, the temperature has more or less stabilized, holding at about 250 Fahrenheit, exactly where we want it. No explosions yet. An hour and a half in, and we start pushing it gradually up to 600. Still no explosions. It's at about 800 Fahrenheit now. We started gently forcing the air with a small electric fan. The kiln insulates very well. It's now over 1,000 degrees Fahrenheit inside, but only 250 on the surface. Unfortunately, this disparity has proven to be a problem, too. Despite using a flameware body, cracks have formed, both in the base and body of the kiln. The cracks are growing. The kiln is also reducing pretty heavily. This means there isn't enough airflow for the amount of fuel we're putting in, probably because the chimney hole is too small. Unfortunately, if we draw back on the fuel, it will start to lose heat. This means that the temperature has effectively stalled out at about 1600 degrees Fahrenheit. It's time to call it. Results of the firing itself are good. Low but uniform bisque, consistent top to bottom, with no fractures or explosions. Got a little copper flashing too, which is nice. Results for the kiln are less good. There were quite a few cracks. I have some ideas that might prevent that, though, as well as a few other design modifications. I want to give it at least one more try before giving up on the idea.